from Builder Boeing. I think you owe you guys a part 2 of my video about a curved screen. And so this is it. If we look to the left, you can see the picture stretches all the way to the left and then over here to the right. So this is actually 180 degrees curved screen. You can see if you have the room here as reference, you can see that it is actually curved. We're still using sheets, so that's why it's a bit uneven here, a bit wobbly there. And that's also why it's a bit unsharp and I need to do a bit of final calibration. But I've done rough calibration and satisfied with the results, so I'm going to proceed with this project. I bought the fly lease program. I'd just like to show you the program. So let's see here. There. That's the fly lease immersive pro program, and it's fairly easy to use. One thing though that caused me a bit of headache to begin with, you need to activate the Nvidia surround function. It's in the Nvidia control panel. You need to do that first. At least I did. I couldn't make it work otherwise. Before I had these letters there, that was one screen and one display, and then over here and the second set of letters, that was display two. Using the surround function, this is now one display and you have the lettering in the middle right there. So before, when I had letters here and here, when I started the program, the second screen over here would just go black. Now it's working. Setting it up, it's actually fairly easy. The way I did it in rough calibration was using my structure behind the screens here. You can see I have 1, 2, 3, 4 vertical supports for projector 1, and then over here is projector 2, 1, 2, 3, 4 supports, okay? Then on the top here I have a horizontal support, a stabilizer, horizontal stabilizers. And I have one down here as well, going behind the screen there. And then on this, on these columns here, I put a small piece of tape and marked it black for each 30 centimeters there, 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 and then we have the stabilizer behind there. So that gives me 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 points on the way down, and 1, 2, 3, 4 columns and 6 rows. So in this program, what you do is you press configure. And then you get a picture that looks like this. You might have seen this before. Over here, you configure the number of points you need. 6, a 4, and 6. And then you can choose a different picture here if you don't want this with all the numbers. But I think that's the easiest one to use. And here you can see all the points. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Number 6 is down there. And then it's actually just a matter of taking the points like the one up here. You can see it goes green there. Then you can just pull it around, and I need to put it right there. Then you take this one and you do the same. But now I haven't removed the screen, so you cannot see the point, the mark behind this the screen, but I'm sure you get understand what I'm getting at. That should give you perfect perfect squares. Because I'm using this sheet and it is not even all the way around, there is a bit of difference. You can see number 4 there is a bit wider than number 1. I'll fine-tune that once I get a better screen, a better material. I've also considered using this. This is a laser, I don't know what's it called in English, but it displays a red arrow. Or a red cross. You can actually see it, you might be able to see it right there around 17. I think in new batteries. You can also use that. It's a matter of getting it on the same line. Then once you've done that, you go in here in the program to blend, and then you start the overlap. First of all you take the projector number 1, and then left or right side. I need to do the right side. And then you can change the overlap, which is the middle where they meet. And when you do that, this happens. Okay, So you need to get that set to the right value so that they meet over there between 16 and 17. And then you can fade the picture. You do that like this. And the fading helps you prevent you from getting two pictures at the same place. That's gonna give you a small white, brighter mark all the way down. I actually got that, and I'm gonna calibrate that later on. You can also see that my 17 row here, or 17 column, is a bit narrow compared to 18, and 16 goes up a bit. That's fine tuning again. I'll take care of that at another time. Once you're finished, remember to click save, and then you're ready. I just need to put this prepared in full screen mode again. There we are. And then you have a result that looks like this. You can actually see that white line, bright line I talked about right there. That's when they meet. Fine tuning later on. I still got some issues. Take a look at that car coming here from the right to the left. Looks fine right now, looks like a car. And then when it goes to the side, it gets very big and just looks very strange. Might have set up prepared in the wrong way. I got one picture, one view, and a very low zoom rate. If I move to see if I can get a picture up from the side, you can see the airplanes here. They look all strange if you look to the side. That's a normal bus and a Boeing 737. I haven't looked into that yet. But this is good. Next, I hope to be able to build the frame so that the picture, the windows kind of encloses the cockpit. I've also started connecting all the things, the overhead, the pedestal, the throttle, the annunciators. Almost everything is working. So there's a bit of building left, and then all the loose wires need to be reconnected. But this is okay. Actually, this is quite good. I'm Peter from Bilderberg. You guys take care.